is Matt O'Kane. Matt, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Very good, Matt. You've been re-assaying some historical drill core here at Santa Teresa, confirming some high grades. Tell us more.
Yes, so we did a re-assay program actually as a part of planning for the drilling program that's sort of just completing right now. And that was to better understand the structure and assist us to plan the drilling. And we obviously just published these results yesterday.
Some surface samples were also taken here, Matt.
That's right. We did a surface sampling and mapping exercise as well. And that was to try and understand more about the geometry of some of these veins which outcrop at surface, and also to map veins that were outcropping at surface which hadn't been intersected in the drilling. Again, giving us as much information as possible to plan the drilling program that we're just completing right now.
Just give us a bit more detail, Matt, on the mapping and sampling. What's that suggesting here?
Well, the mapping and sampling itself was more about just mapping things out on the surface and also taking samples from veins that were outcropping at surface and testing them for grade. And we got some grades up to 9.5 grams per tonne there. Of course, the reassaying of the core itself, the historical core, produced grades up to, you know, over 130 grams a tonne, which is consistent with the high grade results that we saw and the range of grades and results that we saw in the historical assays from the 2008 program. So the surface sampling and mapping was just about getting more information together. And as I said, it's giving us a better picture to plan the drilling program with.
And you've done some early stage met test work on some of the material.
We have, yep. So what we did was we took some pulps from the old program, from samples, and we ran that through metallurgical testing. And the reason that this is of great interest, in fact, is that in any gold deposit, you need to know what your processing pathway is going to be, and importantly, whether you will require leaching in the processing circuit or not. In this case, what we saw was that because of this nuggety effect and the coarse gold in this deposit, as we expected, you had a fair bit of gold that could be recovered just through grinding and gravity separation. And the good thing was that a lot of the other gold, a lot of the residual gold, was able to be recovered using simple flotation. So essentially, you can get recoveries above 90% without the need for leaching, which is cyanide leaching. And so that removes not only a lot of cost out of the processing pathway, it removes a lot of environmental permitting because you're just using just gravity and flotation. And it means that you can create a very, very cheap processing pathway, which if there is a choice to go into production in the future, it really is going to reduce the capital expense to build your processing plant, essentially.
Just back to something you said right at the start there, Matt, the drill program here at Santa Teresa, that's nearing completion, is it?
That's right. Yeah, it's basically just completing at the moment. They're just finishing up. So we should have an announcement coming out soon on the completion of that program. One other thing I skipped over there is that as a result of reinterpreting the core and then the reassaying that was done, one thing we focused on was the possible presence of another gold system there, an epithermal gold system. So the gold system that was identified previously is a mesothermal or load gold system. And it looks possible that there was a subsequent event where we had an epithermal intrusion also. And so that's very interesting, actually, because that means that if you have actually had two events delivering gold into the system down there, into the deposit, then, you know, the potential for gold recovery becomes higher. So it'll be interesting to see whether we notice that in the drilling program assays for the program that's just completing.
Hmm. Matt, just while I've got you this morning, any news, any updates as far as the graphite test work?
Yes, so the graphite test work has been progressing very well, actually, over in Germany. And I'm hoping to get the final results either this week or next week. We've had some interim results, but we want to get the complete picture before we interpret everything and announce it to the market. Hoping to have all of that available in the very near term, and then we'll, of course, share that with the market at that point in time. So that should be exciting.
Indeed. Matt, thanks for your time.
Great. Thanks. Bye-bye.